What are we doing today, Peanut?
Driving to BC. Well, driving to Kamloops or something.
Yeah, that's in BC.
Yeah.
And then from there, where are we going?
To Victoria Island. And we're gonna go stay at the Zed.
Yeah. Your wig is cool.
Yeah.
Alrighty. We got snacks?
Yeah, in the back. And I got my frappuccino in that bottle.
Yep. Alrighty.
Bigger than an actual frappuccino, because an actual frappuccino is like $5.
Well, that wasn't far off. But anyway.
That was $3.
Yeah, okay.
$2 off.
Shall we hit the road?
Yeah.
Okay.
We got McDonald's.
All right, let's go. Food, they run away.
Oi. He nibbled your finger?
Well, we heard a noise on the highway.
Yeah.
We're in Hope. That's not good. I'm gonna see if I can tighten it up. I am at a park store in Loco.
Loco.
It's not hot, so I don't think it's terrible. Oh, come on.
You need to go into the Lord and grab some really great. Singular hit.
my damn phone. Road tripping. The shifter wants to keep falling apart. So, and then yes, the wheel bearing problem, that got solved through Lee at LG Customs. Actually, I ended up using a hub. It's all used stuff. His parts guy knew a guy. Did an exchange. He dropped off a whole spindle and the whole works. I used the hub and the bearing and swapped it over. He was nice enough to let me borrow some shop space to do it.
Okay, what do I take on a road trip? And this is the aftermath of failed wheel bearing and that. But what I do take is
small socket set like this that we got from that's just like a local hardware store brand, Canadian Tire Maximum. It's a good little set though, fairly complete. Channel locks, can't go without channel locks. Then you gotta grab your Milwaukee drill instead of the impact gun to take your wheels on and off. That was a mistake. And it's a various stuff, multimeter, sidecars, tire pressure gauge, jack, and one jack stand.
But yeah, it's just a jumble. I'm actually getting ready to leave Victoria and head back to home. Head back home, back to home, jeez. Yeah, so that was it. Big shout out to Lee at LG Customs for actually letting me use shop space and scaring up the parts through his parts guy, Rick at Bumper to Bumper. Found someone that had used the hub. Actually, the guy brought the whole front assembly with the spindle on out, including the backing plate and drum and everything. I ended up using the hub and the bearings. So, for the front, which kind of saved my bacon. I am going to order the hubs so I can do the conversion to Timken style bearings, because they're still available. I might have done that a long time ago had I known it would have been such a problem getting a set of bearings. The SKF bearings actually discontinued. Anyway, about to head out. I'll reorganize this and throw my luggage in the trunk and go have breakfast and head to the ferry.
thing about a road trip, especially a long one, it's going to shake everything loose. It's going to come loose. My exhaust that was admittedly cobbled together, it's come off that hanger and it was about an inch off the ground, so no bueno. And jack her up, put that hanger back on, and then carry on. I'm kind of taking the Fraser Highway instead of the main highway from here on in anyway, which is kind of like our, it'd be like a little piece of the old abandoned Route 66, kind of. Because once the Coquihalla Pass was put through, everyone takes it, but I'll take the Fraser Valley route. A little more interesting. I'm in no rush. Okay, let's get this exhaust patched up. Got her. Back on the hanger and see how long that stays on there. It's because this all got bent. Had the other mufflers and it caught that raised manhole cover. It bent this pipe back here. It's all, it doesn't line up. The other side's fine, it just all lines up. This here's all bent. Okay. So we have to go to the exhaust shop and get some, probably just pipe from back of the mufflers back, get these welded right onto this pipe up front. Alrighty, back on the road.
Okay, day two of my trip back to Edmonton. Stayed in Cache Creek last night. I was too cooked to just keep driving. Going through the Fraser Valley, had the sun coming in the driver's side. It was just blazing hot. And that was just the afternoon, the earlier part of the day, because there was lots of shade. But then the landscape changes here. You look at the hills. Oh, I'm gonna flip you around. Ah, anyway. But the hills here and everything have no trees on them anymore, so there's no shade. I was just getting, I'm sorry, the fan happened. Switch hands. Yeah, no, so there's no shade and I was getting baked and it was hot in the afternoon and I was just done. So I stopped a little earlier than what I thought. In another hour I would have been in, where I originally intended to go. Kamloops, but no. I was looking up at the hills and stuff here. Oh, can we, how do I flip this thing? Fueled up. Gas station, gas pumps. Oh, BC, relax on the freaking price of fuel. It's all tax. You know, they lower the price and the economy kind of follows suit, but they wouldn't know that. Anyway, back to the land of $1.20 a liter gas instead of $1.70. Yeah. Anyway, time to hit the road. Car's been actually running good. No problem with the wheel bearing or anything so far. And yeah, just good. Hasn't used a drop of oil this whole trip. This motor's been excellent. I've had this car, I guess, 4 years. Memory showed up on Facebook when I did the trade. So yeah, time to roll. Okay, see you in a bit. Creek, give it a try. I had a burger and milkshake, so I can't tell you if the fries are right. Burger was good.
And here's what I was talking about by the landscape. Stop and shoot some video here. Just hitting 70 Mile House, taking the Bill Trail highway. It's kind of a long way. I've never been this way, and I'm glad I did. That service station has some cool old vehicles collection. Don't know if anything's for sale. No one's in. Dead side. Cool Chevy. Do not touch. Oh, phone number. Looks like it's for sale. Don't touch. Just a wagon and a horse. The swing open door, ambulance, possibly. It's almost not long enough for an ambulance or a hearse, but the swing open door says otherwise.
Pretty cool. Automotive restoration. Stuff in there. Not too bad he wasn't open. It is Sunday. People have lives. We need old pumps. Is that Chevy? Chevy or GMC? GMC. Cool truck.
My mother had one of these when I was a kid. Rito 500.
Like even the same year.
What a boat. Awesome.
So landscape changed again. We went from the desert to what I would call boreal forest type landscape, which is similar to northern Alberta. It's amazing how many different landscapes you can drive through.
Phone booth.
Oh, this is a BC rest stop. Alberta, I urge you to step up into the game.
Your rest stops would scare Rob Zombie. Cool.